Which nutrients do we need every single day?
Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode. So RJ Douglas says, I've read through your Vitamins and Minerals 101 course, and it is a great resource. Since there are so many vitamins and minerals to keep track of, I try to eat a well-rounded diet. But for meal planning purposes, it is not feasible to make sure I'm getting the recommended amount of all vitamins and minerals each day. My question is, are there any vitamins and minerals that you recommend getting on a daily basis to help ensure the body functions optimally? Stated another way, are there any vitamins and minerals that the body is particularly poor at storing and as such will effectively deplete itself of its reserves within a relatively short time period? RJ, I would say that the top ones to be concerned about from a have to get it today perspective would be zinc and B12. And both of those have absorption caps that are fairly tight. But B12 is the number one concern. And so generally speaking, you can absorb a day's worth of B12 per meal. And that means that if you want to stock up on B12 and not get it at every meal, the most you can stock up, the tightest you can distribute your B12 across your meals is to get a day's worth of B12 at least one third of your meals through the year. So you can get a day's worth of B12 at all three meals. Now, I'm assuming you eat three meals a day. You have to adjust it otherwise. So you can get a day's worth of B12 at all three meals in January, February, March, and April. And then you can forget about B12 for the rest of the year. Alternatively, you can get all your B12 for the day at one meal every day of the year. And then, if you want to break that down into more permutations, you can. It's just all based on the fact that you can only eat a day's worth of B. You can only absorb a day's worth of B12 in each meal. For zinc, I think it's less less rigidly defined as that, but it's generally true that you're probably not going to get more than 5 to 7 milligrams of zinc per meal. And so you want to, I guess it's kind of similar, but the thing is zinc absorption is very regulated by zinc status. And so I don't think you would be able to like stock up on zinc, in the first 4 months of the year, like I just described for B12, because I think in those 4 months, your zinc absorption is going to go down a lot. Then it's going to go up during the rest of the year when you're not eating zinc, but you're not going to be able to take advantage of it. So zinc is, I think, something where you really want to kind of make sure that you're getting a day's worth on most days. And then most of the B vitamins, most of the other B vitamins they don't have strict absorption caps, but they are limited by the amount of ATP and magnesium they're limited by magnesium status in general, but then on a short-term basis, they're limited by your ATP supply. So, excuse me, when you eat a meal, your ATP levels are going to go up because you're well fed, and the ATP is going to help trap the B and retain the B vitamins. And they don't have, generally their absorption caps, if to the extent they exist, they're limited by that. And generally that's higher than what you would get in food. And so it's less likely to matter. But if you were to try to put all your B vitamins into like liver on certain days, then, or B complex supplements, then at some point you're going to hit a problem with taking more than you can absorb at once and not being able to distribute it. So I would say the B vitamins, I think you generally want to make sure they're somewhat well distributed, but nothing has to be exactly perfectly distributed evenly. So, and then the fat-soluble vitamins are generally going to be more limited by meal size and fat content. And so if your fat content of your meals or the size of your meals varies a lot, take that into account and bias them towards the higher size, higher fat meals. But then otherwise, you don't need to worry too much about how they're distributed. So on the whole, I think that it's better to use a micronutrient tracking app, not so much to make sure that all your meals are hitting the requirements, and not even so much to make sure that all your days are, but more to make sure that on a week-to-week basis, you are on average hitting the daily targets. In other words, if you, and of course, one of the things I recommend doing for people who don't like tracking is take three representative days and track those. But what I hear you saying, RJ, is that your day, 3 days isn't representative for you because you're too up and down. And so if you want representative days and you don't like tracking, you do have to track enough days to actually be representative. The more variable your diet is, the more days that will be to make sure it's representative. But if you love tracking, and it sounds like you're a tracker, if you love tracking and you track every day, then you really shouldn't be focusing on each day. You really should be just printing out a weekly report or a monthly report. I say printing out, exporting how, reporting it however you want. But look at the weekly averages and the monthly averages. And if on a weekly average basis, on a monthly average basis, you are hitting on average the daily targets, then I think that's generally good for most things. And I don't think, I feel like the only people who would care about getting B12 in the way that I described are people who have, cyclically vegan or cyclically plant-based diets. And so I think that, those B12 rules come into play there. And people who could get fooled into thinking that they eat 200 grams of clams once a month, and so they're all set for B12 for the month. They're wrong. But as long as you're not deliberately trying to stock up in a particular way like that as a strategy, you probably don't need to worry about those rules. But if you are trying to deliberately stock up as a strategy, then you do especially want to pay attention to that B12 rule. You want to pay decent attention to the zinc rule, and you do want to make sure that your B vitamins are getting in on most of those other B vitamins, you could probably, as long as you're hitting the daily average on the weekly basis, that's good. But I wouldn't go to the monthly basis for looking at the B vitamins like that. Okay. Thank you for your question, RJ.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. From now through February or March, whatever it takes to get it done, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for my consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.